Okay, so we're just gonna modify the window size back to what we had it, and I believe it was 120, and this one over here was 35, and we will just reposition this over here for the moment. All right, so we're gonna quickly go through this. As you can see in this window section, we have various other subsections, one being the title, the window size, which we talked about, the scrollback, the resume, and minimum window size. At the very top here, there is a title that you can input into this field. To do so, to change the title, you would just double click on the profile that you're modifying, and it'll bring up an additional window. And in this case, change this to Williams K. You can change it to whatever you like, or just leave it as the default. I'm just going to show you how this works. You commit by hitting enter. Then it adds this right here, which is the terminal title. I'm going to uncheck or disable the working directory or document path. So if I do so, you see that disappears. If I re-enable it, it brings back up the folder. For now, I'm going to disable this. I'm going to leave this the same for now. So the active process name just displays the active process name, and this one below displays the argument. And then we're going to jump back up here to the shell command name. If you check this, it'll show what shell you're using, and in this case it's SSH, but I'm also going to remove that. Notice that it's still there, and I'll show you why in a moment. So the next thing down the list is the profile name, and it displays the name of the Windows profile. So if we were to check this, the profile name comes up. And as you can see, the profile name is the name of your profile that we chose. And in this case, I chose Williams. Your profile name will be something else. So I'm not going to display that. I'm going to keep it unchecked. All right. And this one, the TTY, the acronym, this has a little bit of history to it. It dates back to the early 1800s and it's focused around telegraphy. So the telegraph, if you can think of, or I think it stands for the teletypewriter. That's what the acronym is. If you check this, you can see what the name of that is. We'll get into a command that might show that a little bit later and what you can do. But for now, I don't want that to be visible, so I'll uncheck it. I'll also uncheck the dimensions. Lastly, the command key. This displays the key that's used to open up or check the active window. So if you had multiple terminal windows open with tabs, you can see what the command key would be. And in this case, you can see that the one that we're currently working on has a command key of 2. And the other one has a command key of 1. So if you wanted to actually see or switch between those, you would hit Option Command 2 or Option Command 1. And then we're going to move down to scrollback, which is the limit available. Just how far back do you want to scroll back to the commands that you've already typed in? I'm going to leave this to be default. And down here we have resume, where we restore text when reopening windows. So if you're working on something and let's say, I don't know, something happened, your machine died, or something just happened and you just closed it accidentally, or you wanted to just restart terminal and picked up where you left off, this is what you would use here. And it would also insert a bookmark after where the text was restored. So you'd pick up exactly where you left off. For now, I'll just leave that unchecked. And the last one is pretty self-explanatory. So we're all done here. And we're going to close this. We're going to quit this here. We're going to reopen terminal. And we're going to open our preferences once more. So just before we jump into tabs, there's one note here. If you go back to window, and I know I didn't uncheck the active process, but I'd like this on. But if you remove that, you would just see, the name title that you named your terminal all by itself. But for now, I'm going to keep this on as a side note, and we're going to jump into tabs and take a look at that.